The weekend is officially here, everybody. Welcome to hour two of Good Morning Football Weekend. I'm Colleen Wolf with Reggie Bush. Mike Garofolo, look alive,
ears.
Look alive.
Sorry. No, I've got itchy ears today for some reason. Sorry.
That means somebody's talking about you.
I'm sure there's a lot of
people. Michael Robinson as well.
My nose is itchy. That means you're going to get punched in the face, right?
Is it?
No!
I know when your palms are itchy, that means you're going to get money.
Yeah,
right?
That hadn't happened yet.
I don't know.
Waiting on it.
Yes, yeah, still waiting.
Missing a couple
let's get into, though, what happened yesterday at Saints practice, because that is obviously the big news as Dez Bryant went down while going over some routine routes in practice. The initial diagnosis there showed it was a torn Achilles. He also had an MRI to confirm that, so those results are pending. But that's a bad deal for a guy who just signed with the Saints on Thursday. He waited and waited for the perfect opportunity, and it came in the Saints. And just what a bad break for him. That's so frustrating. A ton of players tweeting at him. Cole Beasley, damn bro, I'm sorry. My heart hurts for you, brother. Keep fighting, big dog. You know where I'm at if you need anything. So that's from Beasley. Then we have Michael Thomas. Best believe we throwing up the X still, bro. We all we got.
We all we need.
Jaws chiming in. Prayers for Dez. Uniform aside, because, you know, Eagles, Cowboys. Hate to see a player get injured at any time. Mm-hmm. Dez Bryant there. And Tyrann Mathieu, say it ain't so. Prayers up. What a roller coaster ride, I'm sure, of emotions it's been for Dez. So, Garofolo, what's the latest right now?
Listen, the MRI is what the MRI is, but you know when you tear an Achilles, what's happening there.
Yep.
So they're not holding their breath or anything like that. They know what happened here with Dez Bryant and the torn Achilles. People jumped right to, well, if you're not in camp and you're not around for a while, this is the kind of thing that can happen. Yeah. People said also it happens to older players a lot of times. Sometimes it's just a freak thing. I mean, you can't sit there from the outside and say that this happened to Dez Bryant because he didn't sign sooner, right. He wasn't in camp, mm-hmm. or maybe he wasn't conditioning away from the facility. Yeah. It's just something that can happen at times.
No, I think it's something that can happen. I do think that Dez was probably so excited to be a part of this team.
Now, that could be.
He may have pushed himself a little bit too tough right off the bat. But let's just be honest about this thing. Dez Bryant with the New Orleans Saints, we talked about last hour that maybe his days as a number one receiver is maybe over.
Oh, yeah.
His days as an elite number two receiver probably have just begun.
Yeah.
I think he still has some juice left, I hope, and send great energy his way so that he can get back on the football field. I thought this was a tremendous opportunity for Dez to be able to go through a process of humbling himself to make sure that he's around in this league for a lot longer. I think he's an enigma as a personality. This dude is awesome. He's usually the spark plug for every team he's a part of. It's so sad that this thing happened to Dez Bryant.
Yeah, man, I love the passion that he plays with. Every time he steps on the field, you know, he wants to be great. And that's what you want out of a receiver like that, of a player like Dez Bryant, man, and especially like you just talked about it. Maybe his days as a number one are over, but his days as a number two are just getting started. And so I was very, very excited just to see him play with Drew Brees, to see that relationship develop over the course of the second half of this season. And you knew that they needed him, right? They needed a player like him at this moment. And so I thought he was just going to, you know, go in there. They were going to have some plays for him. You know, it was going to be limited this weekend as well. But just to see the dynamics, man, to see Dez get back to being happy, back to playing football. I actually direct messaged him, send him a message, just thoughts and prayers, man. And we've all been there before. When you feel that pop, you know it's something. You know it's something real.
And Dez replied what? Hasn't replied?
Let me check.
Why is no one replying to Reggie Bush? Come on now.
Let me lay out Reggie. I won't go there. Glad you did.
I'm always here for that. He's checking. While he's checking, this was the career reboot for him because a lot of teams that were interested in him or at least thought about being interested in him this year was, do we need an X receiver, and can he come in and still be that guy? This was his chance through over the last half of the season, and I gather he wasn't interested in anything beyond this season as far as a contract because he wanted to reestablish himself and his value going into the offseason. Can he play a different role? Can he do different things? Yeah. Because once you start to lose that X receiver, number one receiver form, you've got to be able to adapt and do different. I remember I covered years ago, Amani Toomer was the Giants' number one receiver for a number of years, and maybe better than a lot of guys, reestablished himself as a number two and then had a bit of a renaissance through the back end of his career. It's a very tough thing to do for guys.
It's a very tough thing, and most of his career he's played the X, the dominant guy, the guy that dictates coverage, and now he's going to have to learn being off the ball, being able to motion and shift, doing all the different things.
Which is not a bad thing.
Right.
It's not a bad thing.
It's not a bad thing, but as a receiver, as you're motioning, as you do things, defenses change. As an X receiver, a lot of times you're just stationary. You see everything happen to you. Yeah. Dez has to get into this playbook if, you know, he's here after this particular season. If he wants to be that guy in the slot and do some different things, mm-hmm. get in that playbook, because I think it'll be a great opportunity mm-hmm. for Dez to resurrect his career.
It was lining up so perfect, too, with the Saints playing the Cowboys in 2 weeks in Dallas.
Thursday Night Football. I couldn't wait to see that game.
Yeah, it's still going to be a good game, but